She gave birth to a baby boy when she was around 20, and she is engaged to the father of her son. To the best of my knowledge, if she has broken up recently, it is possible, but I don't know. When she was 21, she wrote the following on her social media. Quote, own a house, have three dogs, got engaged, and have a one-year-old, all at 21. So proud of these accomplishments. End quote. So that gives you a bit of information. And so the man that she is engaged to served time in prison for child endangerment, and he faced charges for raping a 14-year-old girl when he was 19. His name is Nicholas Rafter. He is currently 27, and he is a plumber. Now, he had been in prison for almost 5 years after he was convicted of 2 counts of burglary and 1 count of child endangerment. He was accused of drugging and assaulting a 14-year-old girl. He had given her, allegedly, a, quote, drug, intoxicant, or controlled substance to her surreptitiously or by force, threat of force or deception, end quote. And he was charged with RAPE, S battery, and unlawful S conduct with a minor, but the charges were dropped after he pleaded guilty to child endangerment. So that's all he was ultimately charged with, just child endangerment. Not that that's nothing, but I'm saying he did not go to prison for all those other things that I mentioned. So he spent 4 years and 11 months in prison and was released in August of 2017. After he got out of prison, he was placed under an intensive supervised parole for 5 years, and he was subjected to random drug screenings until July of 2022. So it was 3 years after he got out of prison when he started dating Peyton Shires. So that was around 2020. And we don't know if she knew about his past. I would think that she did know, but maybe she didn't. Who knows? Anyway, it seems ironic that at some point she had posted on her own social media, quote, dead P-E-D-O expansive continuum of care for youth and families that includes therapeutic foster care, home-based services, managed care, and behavioral health programs, and much more. Now, she started working for them shortly after getting her license. So remember, it was June of 2023 when she got her license. So that was her first job as a social worker. So she was assigned a 13-year-old boy as one of her clients that she was counseling. We don't know his name. We don't know his situation. Like, we don't know exactly why he needed the counseling or why he was in the program, but there was obviously something, you know, whether he was in foster care or just having some kind of family issues. We don't know. But anyway, here's the thing. On September 27th, 2023, so just a few months after she started working, the mother of this 13-year-old boy contacted the police to report having suspicions that SA was going on by Peyton Shires to her 13-year-old son. She had discovered some texting between her son and Peyton Shires, and one of the messages asked him if his, quote, mother had seen the videos or messages, end quote. She didn't find any videos, though, on the phone, probably because he had erased them. So she turned the phone over to the police, and the detectives examined the phone. They must have, you know, gotten the deleted files back. And they found actual video footage of Peyton Shires having sex with this 13-year-old boy, amongst them doing other types of things, other types of sexual activity. She had actually taken video of this. And there were also inappropriate texts that they found as well. So they had the mother make a phone call to Peyton while the police listened in. And she got Peyton to actually admit that she had had sex with the woman's son. So they interviewed the boy, and he admitted that they had had sex on two occasions in September of 2023. So she was arrested on October 6th, which was actually her 24th birthday. And she was charged with unlawful sexual conduct with a minor, and she was held on $500,000 bond. She posted the bond on October 12th, and she was out to await her trial at home. Now, at this time, her former workplace made a statement. They said, quote, "The National Youth Advocate Program is saddened by the situation involving one of our former employees and a young person served by our organization," end quote. She will have to register as a Tier 2 sex offender for 25 years. And after her prison sentence, she will be on parole for 5 years. Professionals have stated that she might get out in as little as 18 months for good behavior. And that is the case. What are your thoughts? I will share some of mine. First of all, my heart goes out to the victim and his mother for what they have been through. They were looking for help, and they got exactly the opposite. Now, there are a lot of people in society who will say that the victim was not harmed because he enjoyed it, or he didn't say no. But I think we all know better. At only 13 years old, he was a child. And having gone through something like this at such a young age, it could definitely cause a lot of negative effects in his future. So I truly hope that he receives some good therapy to help him. Now, a lot of us are wondering, why did this happen? Why would this young woman, an attractive young woman who had a fiancé and had a degree in social work and knew all about child psychology and knew about the laws, why would she do this? Well, I mean, if I had to guess, now I'm guessing, okay, I don't know, but it seems to me that something like this probably happened to her in her youth. I'm not making any excuses for her, by the way. She had no right to do what she did. But I'm just guessing that something like this had happened to her, and she was repeating the cycle. Unfortunately, that happens a lot. And in her own head, she was probably rationalizing the behavior, just like a lot of people out there. She was probably thinking, well, he wants to, you know, or he seduced me, or something crazy like that, you know. It's not hurting him. He likes it. But she knew well enough to hide it. You know, she knew it was illegal, and she knew that it wasn't good for his mother to find out. That's why she asked him to delete the video off his phone. But I can't even believe she made a video. It's like she had zero sense of anything. Now, another thing that we need to talk about is the prison sentence. Is 4 years and 9 months, is that enough time for what she did? A lot of people will say, hey, if she were a man and the boy was a girl, they would have given her a much longer sentence. And, you know, I would normally say, well, yeah, you know, I think you're right, but remember the fiancé. He got his sentence practically the same thing. It was like he served 4 years and 11 months for a crime which, in my opinion, sounds worse than what she did. Because not only had he essayed a 14-year-old, he had also drugged her, and he got a similar sentence. So I don't think we can say she got a short sentence for being a female. Do we believe that her sentence is long enough? Is it enough of a punishment, number one? And will she reoffend when she gets out, number two? It's hard to say. You know, maybe she'll learn something, she'll hear something while she's in prison that will make her think differently in the future. Or at the very least, maybe she'll just learn that